Now I will go ahead and mount the ultrasonic ranger mount on top of one of the seats for the servo. I'll start by taking out the ultrasonic ranger mount. It is covered by protective paper and I'll peel it off. If necessary, I can use the help of screwdriver or a small knife or something, or scissors, but typically we can simply use fingers and peel it off. The shape is not very simple, which means that it will tear off quite often, but that is not a problem in terms of peeling off the pieces. We can easily peel off whatever is left. Here is this ultrasonic ranger mount. It has a relatively complex design and a lot of holes. So peeling it will take slightly longer than you would anticipate for peeling such small item like this one. This side is done, and now we will repeat the same procedure with the second side. Seems like the paper on this side is a little tighter, but sooner or later we're going to get one of the corners, and once when we get one corner, from there, yes, like this one, from there it shouldn't be like that. Now I'm a little bit more experienced, so I think we'll have slightly less tears. Yeah, this side goes easier than the other. It will be interesting to see whether or not I can make it into one single piece. That would be something with this complex shape. And yes, I did it. Oddly enough, I succeed to peel it without tearing it even a single time. That's some achievement. Now the next step is to figure out how we'll mount the mount on the seats. We have three different seats. And now we have to see which one fits the best. So it will be one of those two seats. Since we have only two screws, we can probably use either one of them. I'll use this symmetric one. The other one is slightly isometric, with one side longer than the other. And now I will need these two long screws, which I'll drive through the two holes here into the seat. We see a lot of the mounting options, and I will briefly consult with the menu. Yes, as expected, the idea is to put these screws from these openings on the top and into the seat on the bottom. So start with one of them. Make sure I pick the right hole to insert. So this one seems fine. Yes. And I will use this really small Phillips screwdriver from the set to slightly, for now, start tightening it into the hole. I'm not gonna over-tight it to make sure that I can insert and place the second screw in properly. And the seat will be symmetric. So I'll start the second one. And everything seems fully symmetric with the central hole in the center of the mount. And now I can go ahead and tighten the two screws in place. Again, I can do them a little bit at a time, each of them. Make sure it's fully perpendicular toward the seat. Now I'm slowly tightening them into the seat. The mount is almost ready. Come on, people. Suggest that you can cut the extra parts from the seat. I don't see any reason to do that, but if you decide, you can cut the sticking out parts from the seat. So this is it. We have the seat placed properly on the mount. The next step would be to put the ultrasonic ranger and then mount the whole mount on top of the servo. Now I will go ahead and mount the ultrasonic ranger on its mount with the help of these four really small bolts. I'll take them from the back so we can easily access them. I will use scissors to cut the ultrasonic ranger back and take the ultrasonic ranger out. The ultrasonic ranger will be mounted like this on the ultrasonic stand. Now I will put the bolts from behind, since they're really with really small heads. Drive them through the board and put nuts on this side. The nuts are slightly bigger and will not go through the openings of the mount. Do not over tight, just loosely tight this bolt, very loosely, so we can adjust the sensor. Carefully repeat the procedure. Use a small Phillips type screwdriver from the set. Place the nut. Do not tight. And do that other diagonal. It's always recommended to do the diagonals first to allow for tension to be released across the component we're mounting. Two nuts, and once when this is done, we can tighten everything in place. Okay, here it is. Now we have our ultrasonic ranger prepared to be mounted on the chassis.